Good morning. I hope
good morning,
ma'am. Yesterday's class, did the homework, yesterday's homeworks and all, is it okay? You tried that questions? They gave, day before yesterday, gave some questions for homework and from straight lines. Did you try that question? Any doubt in that part?
No, ma'am, sure.
Okay. So, any doubt in straight lines? Annette? No.
No, ma'am. No.
So today we are going to start with the next chapter, new chapter. Write the heading: conic sections. Conic sections. Conic sections. C-O-N-I-C. Conic section. Can you tell me what does mean by conic section? Conic section. Can you guess what is conic section?
Section of a cone.
Yes, we are going to learn about different sections of a cone. What are the different sections of a cone? Okay. So what are the different sections of a cone? Okay, listen, children. So conic sections, we are going to learn about different sections of a cone. So in order to learn a different section of a cone, we should learn how a cone is generated, how we are going to generate a cone. For that, initially we are having a fixed line L. Okay, suppose you have a fixed line L and we have another line M which is inclined at an angle alpha. Okay, these two lines intersect at a point B. Okay, so let L be a fixed vertical line and M be another line intersecting at a point B and inclined at an angle of alpha. Suppose we rotate this line. Imagine we are rotating this line. Okay, we are continuously moving. Okay, this point is fixed. So when it moves continuously, what happens? We will be getting a cone. Okay, this one we have learned in 9th standard also. Double cone. When we rotate a line, when we rotate a right angle, whether we'll be getting a cone, fix one side. Okay, suppose I fix this side and we keeping this side fixed. When we rotate, what you will get? In three dimension, you will get it as a cone. Same way, you have one line fixed and another line is making an angle alpha with the fixed line. So we rotate this line. This fixed line is kept there. This line, if you move on rotating, we will be getting a cone. This surface generated is a double napped right circular hollow cone. Okay, this name is given by Apollonius, the mathematician who gave this. It is called double napped cone. He will get two cones, one top cone and bottom cone. So this fixed line, okay, and this line will meet at a point. This point we call it as vertex of the cone. So this is how we are getting a cone. Okay, one fixed line is there and one another line is rotating with respect to this fixed line. So we'll be getting a cone. So from this cone, what are the different sections we are going to get? That's what we are going to learn it now. Is it clear? What is meant by conic section? Is it clear? From a cone. Okay, now we have got a cone. From the cone, what are the different sections are there? What are the equations? All these things we are going to learn in this chapter. Conic section is an important chapter. Okay. In physics and all, you will be using this curves important. Parabola. Okay. You'll be using in physics particularly. Okay, here we are going to learn how to find the equations. All this. Okay, how to frame an equation. If an equation is given, how to find the center, focus, all these things we are going to learn. Now, okay, now look at this, the same cone. Okay, this is the fixed line and this is the line L. When we rotate it, we'll be getting a double napped cone. This fixed line, this fixed This fixed cone once sir, I think no without name, simply two dots came and I didn't allow that one. Maybe that one without the name, so I thought I did. Sometimes and this one sometimes smaller kids are coming in the same thing. So children, when you are entering the class, okay, you come with the name, okay, mention your name there, otherwise you will not be able to understand who is entering. Okay, so what you are discussing, we are discussing about conic section. Okay, different sections of cone. So one line is there, we keep one fixed line and we rotate one line. This fixed line we call it as axis. The fixed line is called the axis of the cone, and the line which is rotating we call it as the generator of the cone. It is called the generator. The point where the line and axis, this axis and the generator meets, we call it as vertex. The point where the axis and generator meets, we call it as vertex of the cone. Okay, and the cone is divided into two names. Okay, if we take, now listen children, imagine you have a cone. Okay, so now you take one section of a cone. Okay, for example, you take carrot. Usually we give an example for carrot, isn't it? If you cut a carrot with a knife, you can take it as a plane. What are the different sections? What are the different shapes you are going to get? That's what we are going to learn here. Sections of cone. Okay, imagine, suppose a carrot, usually give an example for conical shape. Okay, it is a solid one. Cut it with a knife. If we cut it parallel, what is the shape you will get? If you keep the knife slanting position and you cut, what you will get? That's what we are going to discuss it here. If we take the intersection of a plane, if we take the intersection of a plane with the cone, the section so obtained is called a conic section. Thus, conic sections are the curves obtained by intersecting a right circular cone by a plane. What is meant by a right circular cone? What is a right circular cone? We are learning about right circular cone, right circular cylinder. What is meant by right circular cone and right circular cylinder? Yes? Yes, very good. The angle between the height and the radius. Okay, so this is, okay, this is a radius, this is a height. If the angle is 90 degree, we call it as right circular cone. Okay, similarly, cylinder, we call it as right circular cylinder if the radius and height are at 90 degree. Sometimes we have used to make cylinders in this shape and all, we used to see here. Radius is not perpendicular. Okay, so right circular cone, we are discussing about only the right circular cones. Now look at this, children. I'll show the next figure. Look at this. These are the sections, different sections of cone. If you cut it parallel to it, you will get circle. If you cut like slantingly, you will get ellipse. You'll be getting a circle, ellipse, the slanting portion. Only one part you will cut. Look at here. Okay. If you are cutting this parallel to the base, you will get a circle. Okay, if you cut it still somewhat slanting position, then you will get ellipse. If you cut only one part of the cone, you will get parabola. And if you cut both the sides, you will get a hyperbola. So these are the four different sections of a cone. The different sections of a cone are circle, ellipse, parabola, and hyperbola. These are the four different sections we are going to learn. Different sections of a cone. How will you get the section of a cone? When a plane and the cone intersects. When a plane and a cone intersect, you will get different sections of the cone. The different sections are circle, ellipse, parabola, and hyperbola. These are the four different sections we are going to learn. Is it clear? What is meant by conic section? Is it okay, children? Anila Mohanan, is it clear? What is conic section? The different sections of a plane obtained by cutting a cone with a plane, we call it as conic sections. What are the four different types you are going to learn? Achyut, what are the four different types of different sections you will get?
Ellipse.
Ellipse. Yes.
Parabola.
Parabola.
Circle.
Circle.
I forgot the fourth one.
Fourth one is hyperbola. Fourth one is hyperbola. Ellipse. Okay, the first one is circle, hyperbola, parabola, ellipse. Total we have four different sections. So we are going to learn each one by one. The first thing we are going to learn is about circle. The first thing we are going to learn is a circle. Okay. So the first thing we are going to learn is a circle. Now tell me, what you have learned so many things about circle. Can you define circle? What is a circle?
The distance between the center and the boundary will be equal.
Little more you can, okay. It's not the proper definition. Okay, center and all we define only after defining the circle. What is a circle? Yes, Atul?
It is a 2D figure obtained by rotating a line segment along a fixed point.
By rotating, okay, it is a 2D, okay. Then, but what's the definition you are learning? What you said is correct. But what is a circle? Actual definition, mathematically how we define? It is the collection of, it is the collection of all points. It is the collection of all points at a fixed distance from a fixed point. It is the collection of all points at a fixed distance from a fixed point. Okay? From a fixed point. Instead of saying collection, sometimes we use the word locus. Locus means it is collection, a group of. A collection of points which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point. From a fixed distance from a fixed point. It is the collection of points in a plane which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point. And what is this fixed distance called? This distance, we call it as radius. This fixed distance, we call it as radius. And the fixed point, we call it as
center.
Okay, so what is circle? It is the collection of points which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point. That fixed point we call it a center, and the fixed distance we call it as radius. Okay. So then what else we have learned about circle? Recall the points what you have learned about circle. So the fixed point, we call it a center. Center, we usually denote it as O, and this is the radius. Then what else you have learned about circle? Once you learn about circle, center is there, radius is there. What's the next thing we'll be learning? The next point, what you'll get? Radius is given. The next is?
Diameter.
Diameter. Okay, what do you know about the diameter?
2 times the radius.
It is the 2 times the radius. It is the longest chord. It is the longest chord. Okay, so now here we are going to find, okay, we are going to learn the general form of equation. We are going to learn the general form of equation of circle. Write the heading. Equation of a circle. Equation of a circle. Now listen, children. Suppose O is the center. Okay. Suppose O, the center is given by H comma K. Suppose the center is given by H comma K, and P of X comma Y be any point on the circle. Let P of X comma Y be any point on the circle. So for what we know about OP, OP will be the radius, isn't it? Suppose H comma K be the center. Suppose the center O is given by H comma K, and let P of X comma Y be any point on the circle. Okay, it is any point on the circle. Then the distance OP, we call it as, we denote this as R, the radius of the circle. It is the radius R of the circle. Now, is it possible to find OP? Can you find the distance OP, length of OP? OP, can you use distance formula? What is OP? If you use distance formula, if the point is H comma K and the other one end is X comma Y, using distance formula, what is OP? Root of the distance formula. What is distance formula? Suppose X1, Y1 is one point and X2, Y2 is the another point. Then the distance AB is given by root of X2 minus X1 the whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 the whole square. So that is here. What will be OP? If you apply the distance formula, it is X minus H the whole square plus Y minus K the whole square, which is same as R. So root of X minus H the whole square plus Y minus K the whole square is equal to R square, is equal to R. Now you square on both the sides. When you square on both sides, root will get cancelled. So when you're squaring on both sides, X minus H the whole square plus Y minus K the whole square is equal to R square. So this is the equation of the circle. It's the equation of the circle. Equation of the circle whose center is H comma K and radius is R means it is X minus H the whole square plus Y minus K the whole square is equal to R square. X minus H the whole square plus Y minus K the whole square is equal to R square. Is it okay? Is it clear, children? Is it okay? Okay. So what is the equation of this circle, Ashwin Binil?
I'm didn't complete.
Didn't complete. Okay. Complete it. Okay. OP, we are finding the distance OP using distance formula. OP is same as radius R. Distance formula is X2 minus X1 the whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 the whole square. Equating it, we are getting this equation. So the equation of the circle with center. Okay. Equation of the circle with center H comma K. With center H comma K and radius R. The radius R is given by R square is equal to X minus H the whole square, Y minus K the whole square. So this is the equation of the circle. Now is it over, Ashwin? Complete, Ashwin?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, okay, instead of center H comma K, suppose the center we are taking as A comma B. Suppose the center is A comma B and the radius is R. Can you give the equation?
X minus A square plus yes. Y minus B square is equal to R.
So R square. Yes. X minus A the whole square plus y minus b the whole square is equal to r square. X minus a the whole square plus y minus b the whole square is equal to r square. Now, suppose the center is 0, 0. Suppose the center is 0, 0 and the radius is r. And the radius is r. Sania, can you give the equation of the circle?
X square plus y square is equal to r square.
X square plus y square is equal to r square. This is the equation of the circle with center 0, 0 and the radius is r. Okay, the equation of the circle with center 0, 0 and the radius is r. Okay, so what about the equation of a circle? Yes, Achut?
I didn't complete, ma'am.
That one I'll show. I'll show it. Okay, sorry. Okay, wait. Okay, what is the general form of equation of circle? Diya.
X square, x minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square equal to r square.
What about h and k? What are this h and k? H and k? Yeah, h comma k are the center. Okay, the center is given by h comma k. If the center is given by h comma k and the radius is r, then the equation of the circle is x minus h the whole square plus y minus k the whole square is equal to r square. Okay, Achut, complete this one.
Completed, ma'am.
What Diya? Is it over? Yes. Okay. What about the other children? You all copied this one? Now let us do problems based on this. Write the question. Find the equation of the circle. Find the equation of the circle with the first one, center 2 comma minus 6 and radius 5. Find the equation of the circle with center 2 comma minus 6 and radius is 5. Okay, center, we denote this as h comma k, isn't it? Therefore, h comma k is 2 comma minus 6 and radius we denote this as 5. See, each and every time you have to write, for each and every question you have to write the formula and then you have to solve. Okay, for each and every question make it practice to write the formula. So what is the equation of circle? Equation of the circle with center h comma k and the radius r is x minus h the whole square plus y minus k the whole square is equal to r square. So, x minus 2 the whole square, h is equal to 2, k is minus 6, plus y minus of minus 6, so it will become plus 6 the whole square is equal to 5 square. Okay, after this what we have to do, we have to expand this. We can expand this using the identity a plus b the whole square or a minus b the whole square. Expand it, simplify, group it and bring all the terms to one side and write. Rijas, expand and tell me what is x minus 2 the whole square. Rijas. What about x minus 2 the whole square?
X square minus 4x plus 4.
Yes, x square minus 4x plus 4 plus. Femina, what about y plus 6 the whole square? Femina.
Ma'am, y square plus 12y plus 36.
Yes, correct. Is equal to 25. Equal to 25. Okay, now arrange it. Okay, first you write x square term, then y square term, x square term, then y square term, then x term. When we write this, when we write the equation of the circle, this is the form we will write. X square term, y square term, x term, then y term, then the constants. Plus 4 plus 36 minus 25 equal to 0. Equal to 0. So that is x square plus y square minus 4x plus 12y plus, what is the answer? Plus 4 plus 36 minus 25.
15.
Plus 15 equal to 0 is the required equation of the circle. Is the equation of the circle. Okay. Is it okay, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Yes.
We can make it x into x minus 4 plus y into y plus 12 plus 15, right?
Don't write like this. This is the standard form. Okay. For a straight line, what is the standard form we used to say? Ax plus by plus c is 0, isn't it? For the circle, okay, for the circle, okay, it is not in your text, okay? Yeah, the form is like this. Ax square plus ay square, okay, x square term, y square plus, plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is 0. This is the form you use.
Okay.
Y square term, x term, y term, constant. Okay. Earlier we had all those things in your 11th standard, but now it is deleted. So this is the form, standard form you will do. This is how we write the circle. Circle means we should have x square term, y square term, and look at the coefficient of x square and y square, it will be same. Okay, once the equation is given, you can identify it. The coefficient of x square and y square should be same. Then x term, y term, and then constant. This is the standard form you will get. Okay, like a straight line. The standard form of a straight line, we used to say ax plus by plus c is 0. The same way, the standard equation of a circle is ax square plus ay square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is 0. Okay. Is it clear, Aryan? Shall we do this one? Okay. Write the question. Find the equation of the circle. Find the equation of the circle with center 1, 1. Find the equation of the circle with center 1, 1 and radius root 2. And radius root 2. Equation of the circle with center 1, 1. And the radius is root 2. Emmanuel, give the steps, Emmanuel. How will you find the equation of the circle whose center is 1, 1 and radius is root 2? Emmanuel?
Yes, ma'am. Equation of the circle.
Yes. What is the equation of circle?
X minus h whole square.
Yes.
Plus y minus k square. Equal to r square.
R square. Okay. So that here h comma k is same as 1, 1. So when you substitute this.
X minus 1 whole square.
Yes. Good.
Plus y minus 1 whole square equal to root 2.
No whole square. Now, okay, Mohammad Adil, expand and give dance. Expand it using the identity and tell me what do you get. Muhammad Adin?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, expand it. You can use a minus b the whole square, doesn't it?
X square minus 2x plus 1.
Yes.
Plus y square minus 2y plus 1. Is equal to 2.
So next you can x square
minus 2x plus y square minus 2y is equal to 0.
Minus 2x minus 2y equal to 0. Okay. Whenever we write, we'll write the equation of circle, try to write it in general form itself. Therefore, the equation of the circle is x square plus y square minus 2x minus 2y equal to 0. Shall we do the next one? Is it over? Nandana? Shall we move
on? Yes, ma'am.
Krishna Chandran?
Yes, ma'am.
Write the next one, children. Find the equation of the circle. Find the equation of the circle with center. With center, negative A comma negative B. With center, negative A comma negative B. And radius, is root of A square minus B square. And the radius is root of A square minus B square. Center is given as negative A comma negative B, and the radius is root of A square minus B square. Shubham, can you give the equation of circle? Shubham. Shubham? Shubham? Give the equation of circle, Shubham. Equation of circle. If the center is h comma k and radius is r, what is the equation of the circle? I think you have some network issues. Okay. Is it okay? Is it clear? How to find the equation of circle? Is it okay? Okay. Now, Ray, give the equation of circle. Now, Ray.
X minus h whole square plus y minus k whole square equal to r square.
Yeah. Okay. So when you apply the center as minus a and minus b, h comma k is minus a and minus b. When you apply this, what do we get? Now,
x plus a whole square plus y plus b whole square equal to root of a square minus b square whole square.
Is equal to root of a square minus b square the whole square. Very good. Okay. So in the next step, we can expand this. When we expand it, you will get x square plus 2ax plus a square plus y square plus 2by plus b square is equal to is equal to root time square will get cancelled, so we'll get a square minus b square. So simplify, cancel the terms, and grouping. What is the final answer? What is the equation? Gayatri, what is the equation of the circle you will get here?
X square plus y square plus 2ax plus 2yb plus 2b square.
Plus b square. Okay. Is equal to 0. Okay. Is it okay? You all completed this one? Okay. Now listen, children. Suppose you are given an equation of a circle. You are given it an equation of circle and one point is given. Equation of circle is given and point is given. And suppose you are asked to find where the point lies. Is it lying outside or is it lying inside or is it on the circle? How will you decide? Suppose you are given a circle and a point. Okay. Suppose we are given a circle and a point. Okay, suppose O be the center. So in which case you will see the point P lies outside? In which case you will say the point P lies on the circle and it is lying inside? Suppose P lies on the circle, then what we can say? What can you say about the distance OP? Distance OP will be same as?
Radius.
Radius. Okay, if the distance OP is same as the radius, then we can see the point P lies on the circle. What about this case? The second case, here.
Less than the radius.
Yes, whenever the distance OP is less than the radius, then we can say the point P lies inside the circle. And what about the third case?
Greater than the radius.
Greater than. When OP is greater than the radius, we say the point P lies outside the circle. Now write the question. Does the point 2, minus 1 lie inside? Does the point lie inside, outside, or on the circle? Or on the circle, x square plus y square is equal to 9. Does the point 2, minus 1 lie inside, outside, or on the circle? Look at the equation of the circle given here. Equation of the circle is x square plus y square is 9. That means the center is 0, 0 and the radius is, this one we can write this as x minus 0 the whole square plus y minus 0 the whole square is 9. We can write this as 3 square, isn't it? So the distance is, radius is 3. Now what is the point given here? 2, 1. Okay. So the point is 2, -1. Origin, you take it as find the distance OA. Find the distance OA. What do you get? It is root of 2² + -1², isn't it? It is root 5. So tell me where the point will lie. Is it inside or outside? Root 5. Is it greater than 3 or less than 3?
Less than.
Less than. Therefore the point P lies inside the circle. Therefore the point P lies inside the circle. Okay? Okay, children. Okay, in the next class. Okay, one more period is there. That time we'll be continuing with similar type of questions. Thank you, children. We end the session now.